First of all, getting into Team Pulse is like a very ideal situation for me. I mean, I changed from a very experienced marathon team from now to an even more experienced team, especially for the Cape Epic. And I could see straight away that everything is like running smooth in the team, and everyone knows what he or she has to do. So I felt nearly from the start like welcomed, and also that I don't have to actually tell them what to do. So that was great to know. That calms you down when you come to a new team, because I'm also an experienced rider, so I had like experience in the past that the mechanic is, for example, not so into the material, and so you first have to teach the mechanic what he has to do. And what also comes with Team Pulse is like my partner Karl Platt is, it's great to ride with him. He has so much experience in the Cape Epic and also all over the years. I can even learn a lot from him. And now starting in the Epic, where we are now, I really have to say I'm enjoying it much more than with any other partners so far. It's fantastic to see that you, even if it's a hard race, you can still enjoy it in a way. So I think that was for me the most the biggest riddle over the whole thing, to change from one team to the other, where I was like I was in the other team for 10 years, and now to coming to a new team, also to a new bike. We got a new bike just before the Epic, in the week before, and I would say also the old Wild Edge was already a good bike, but this bike feels with the modern geometry, it feels straight away like it really wants to race, and for me it felt very easy to change also, because it has this the stabilizing geometry on kinematic, so if you go fast the bike stabilizes on its own. So that's for me very important. Yeah, getting the bike just 1 week before the start of a big race like the Cape Epic is for sure a little bit of risk, but the bike is that perfect. I mean, we had like very experienced guy to develop this bike, and that you can see straight away. I was feeling I liked it from the beginning, the modern style of the bike, and sure, I was a little bit scared that like you have a bike, not even riding it with a prototype. Usually it gets from a prototype to a serious bike, and then you have, but in the Epic with these rough conditions, it's for sure a little bit of risk. But I was talking to Carl, and he said if they give a bike free, it's for sure 100% safe to ride it in even in the Epic. And I said, okay, if Carl says that, then I'm pretty sure it will survive, and it's doing well so far. The prologue we had in the Epic, we had like quite a bad start with a mechanical, but it was a riding mistake. I hit a stone very bad, so I had a flat tire. That was not good for the position and for the time. It was not a smooth start into the Cape Epic, but the first stage was already really, really good. With a podium, I was not expecting that. I mean, you have a new partner, you don't know how the partner is. We had for sure some weeks of training together, but you never really know until the race is how you like perform together. And we had like in the race we found our rhythm, we got into it, and in the end we were like racing for the podium, and then both of us, we got straight into, like you could see the in our eyes that we are hungry for that, and then we managed to be third in the first stage, and that was a kind of a relief for us to for both of us, because we knew we put a lot of effort, a lot of training into it, and it was a good sign for the next days. Yeah.